Good morning. Just doing a garden update today. My last garden video was 3 weeks ago, and I just wanted to share what's been happening. So I'm just going to cut in a shot of my garden 3 weeks ago. So over here is our zucchini patch. We have 11 plants, 11 out of 12 came up. They have been blooming, lots of blooms. And there's actually a zucchini starting down there, if you can see that. This is our main crop right here. They have a long shelf life. They keep us going for a long time. Along this fence here, we had peas and beans. And we got three pickings out of the peas. I pulled them all up, dried some of the pea pods, and replanted them, and maybe we'll get another crop. We're not too sure. We have some beans here. In this little pot, these were popping up in another area. They're not zucchini, but they're some kind of squash. So I just put them in this pot. This pot here actually doesn't have a bottom on it. And the reason why I did that is if I just planted it, a small plant like that, I'd probably step on it or accidentally yank it out when I was weeding. So this way it stands out a bit more. In this little area right here, which is, I don't know, maybe 3 by 5 feet, I planted lettuce. And you can just see we have lots and lots of lettuce. Too much, actually. We're getting all lettuced out. Last night I made lettuce wrap tacos. But a person can only eat so much. I just wasn't expecting it all to come up like that. And in front here we had peas as well. And we replanted. It's a couple of beans. This right here looks like dill, but it's actually a parsnip that self-seeded from last year. I'm just going to let it go to seed and collect them. We have some onions here. Two potatoes. Like, I wasn't really expecting to plant any potatoes. We just happen to have a couple of soft ones in the house that I threw in the ground. But every year our garden is different. This year we have two hills of potatoes. Next year we might have 12. And we try to plant them in different areas so they're not always in the same spot. Over here we have another squash coming up that was popping up. Our beets are finally coming along. This row here was originally cucumbers, but they didn't grow, so I threw some peas in. I think in that last video they were just starting to pop up, and now they are going to be blooming here right away. We had quite the gap between these two rows. So just a couple weeks ago, I picked up some more cucumbers. I soaked the seeds for a few hours and planted them, and they actually came up. I don't know if there's enough time in our short season for them to mature, but it's worth a try. We have one row of carrots that are doing really good. And our Swiss chard, not too sure what's going on with it. It wants to go to seed. You can see the seeds developing on the top. I've even been cutting those off, and they just not doing very well this year. This is normally what does really well for us. We usually have freezer bags full of this stuff, but nothing so far this year. And over here, actually, I used my sled as a trellis. I planted some more beans back there just a couple weeks ago. And our dill, we cut that down once. We made cream potatoes with dill. It was really good. So it looks quite different from last time. And this is my grapevine I showed in my last video. It is hardy for the prairies, and you can see, maybe, we're getting some grapes. Pretty cool. And this is my red currant plant. It has just been producing so many red currants. You can make jelly out of it. What I've done so far is just made a nice sauce out of it. Just put the berries and some water in a pot, bring it up to a boil, strain it through a metal strainer, put it back in with sugar and honey and reduce it. It's a really good sauce for different things. And here's our apple tree. You can see it's got lots of apples. This is the most apples it's ever had, so I know it doesn't seem like a lot, but for us it is. And in this corner, we have raspberries, quite a bit taller than in my last video, which was just 3 weeks ago. This is more of like a wild raspberry, and it starts to produce fruit mid-July. And this is another kind of raspberry, and it doesn't produce fruit till September, which is good, because right now we're just getting so many raspberries, and we haven't been preserving anything really, just been kind of eating, snacking on things as we go. And this area over here is our raspberry patch. I know it doesn't look like a lot. I actually had to cut some of it down, and I transplanted some of these plants in my yard. But we've been coming out here every second day and getting a nice basket full. And normally we pick, wash, and freeze, and then make jam with it, but so far we've just been eating them as we've been picking them. Same with the peas and just about everything else. And over here is my raspberry and rhubarb patch I just started maybe a month and a half ago. I transplanted some raspberries from other areas of my yard. So I have 3 rhubarb plants and 6 raspberries. And this just needs more time.